Can I take this off? Is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm trying not to spit that far when I'm talking. My name is Bishop Keck. I am Corey's bishop up on campus. It's an honor and pleasure to be here. I'd like to welcome everybody here, both families, Soulsburg, Maryland. Wow, it's a long drive. I'm sure you didn't drive. I'm kidding.
They did.
No, we didn't.
This is Rick's family. This is Kimberly's face. Anyway, are we ready for everybody to come in?
Yeah.
Captain Brad, ready? Could everybody stand, please? Let's be by Corey and fill in.
I was alone. We danced the night away. We drank too much. I held your hand back when you thought it all. When you smiled over your shoulder, for a minute I was so cold sober. I pulled you closer to my chest. There goes my heart, cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please calm down. There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing.
You can see it. So Corey, you give me a lot of instruction here. this was really quick. I was standing in the hospital with my son-in-law and my daughter yesterday, and I get. I suppose I'm looking at my calendar. I'm available. I am pleased that he would trust me enough to invite me to do this. I don't do a lot of these. Thank goodness that most of these are done in the temple. And unfortunately, the circumstances didn't allow us to be there today. As I was preparing for this, I took some liberty here. I was just looking at some thoughts that were important. Kind of invite a little bit of the spirit here today. Some things that I gleaned from this. If you guys okay, talk for a minute.
Yeah.
You guys want to do this to get this over with?
Yeah.
So once it gets started, it's all right. It says the Savior taught, greater love hath no man. You can hold your They tell me a good high counselor and always wear glasses. I don't know about a good bishop. It says the Savior taught, greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Couples can learn a powerful lesson from this teaching. As a spouse, essentially lay down your whole life and to sacrifice many of your personal desires for your closest friends, the husband and wife. The more you are able to put your spouse first and keep your focus on the success of your partnership, the stronger your marriage will be. So a lot of things that we carry into a marriage that we need to say, you know what, that's not as important as the first one you're married today. And here's something that I really, I should have heard the day that I got married. It isn't your spouse's job to make you happy all the time. Both of you need to work to cultivate happiness in your marriage. So take time to talk, to laugh, and to have fun. So being married, and this is the part I really like, being married means that you'll see every side of your spouse, the good, the bad, the strengths, the flaws. Did you guys know you have those? You can ask anyone who's been married here. You'll see things that are completely different than what you see when you're dating and engaged. Anyway, Help build your partner's confidence. That's big. Okay. Give strength to his or her weaknesses. Give compliments instead of criticism. It says here from Ephesians 4:32, be ye kind to one another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, hath forgiven you. So just some thoughts I want to share. You ready for this? Should we do this? I'll leave the light. All right. I won't waste any more time. So please take each other by the right hand. Corey Taylor Ricks and Kimberlyn Pearl Moyle, you have taken one another by the right hand in the token of the vows you will now enter into in the presence of God. Do we have witnesses? I apologize. We got the dads.
We got it.
You guys are now witnesses. Congratulations. Corey Taylor Ricks, do you receive Kimberlyn Pearl Moyle as your lawfully wedded wife? And do you, of your own free will and choice, solemnly promise, as her companion and lawfully wedded husband, that you will cleave unto her and none else, that you will observe all the laws, responsibilities, and obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Success. Kimberly Boyle, or Pearl Boyle, do you receive Corey Taylor Ricks as your lawfully wedded husband? And do you, of your own free will and choice, solemnly promise as his companion and lawfully wedded wife that you will cleave unto him and none else, that you will observe the laws, responsibilities, and obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish him as long as you both shall live?
Thank you.
By virtue of the legal authority vested in me as an elder of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, I pronounce you, Corey Taylor Rick and Kimberlyn Pearl Moyle, husband and wife, legally and lawfully wedded for the period of your mortal lives. I'm going to pause just for a second. When are you going to the temple? Do it quickly, okay? Yeah. That statement just scared me to death. May God bless you with joy in your posterity and a long life of happiness together. And may he bless you to keep sacred the vows you have made, the blessings I invoke upon you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I present to you now, as you have to exchange rings. That's Kennedy's fault. She told me to do it.
I can't ever get the ring on.
There we go. There you go. Congratulations. Yay!
Oh.